Hey guys, if you're new to running, you need to check this video out. I've got some more top tips that are going to help you as you start running. Hey guys, what's up? I'm Chris Ford, aka 40. Thanks for coming back to the channel. If you are new to the channel, make sure you're hitting that subscriber button down below. Hitting that subscriber button is going to help you stay up to date with all my latest running videos. I've got plenty of stuff coming onto the channel, so make sure you hit that subscriber button below. As I said, this video is for you new runners out there. I've got more top tips for you, so let's get stuck in. This video is for all the new runners out there, anybody who's thinking about taking up running. I thought I'd put something together which may help you. It's probably some stuff that I wish I'd known when I started running, so I thought I'd share those points with you. I think one of the main things to think about when starting running, and probably something I wish I'd done, was on the gear with regards to running equipment / gear. I think the important thing there I wish I'd known was to go get my shoes fitted. I've barked on about this before in another video I did, which was, I think it's my running essentials. I'd definitely check that video out if you're new to running. I just talk about all the different bits of gear that I find useful and I use to run. But I think if you should do anything, is to go and get your shoes fitted. I wish I'd done that. I mean, I spent probably too much money wasted on shoes that didn't fit me properly, or they were the wrong sort of shoes. So take the time, if you're gonna run, go down and get a pair of shoes fitted. You can go to Sports Direct, anybody like that, they do it. And just get on one of their machines and get them to check it. You know, whether you're a overpronator or whatever, whether you need a neutral shoe, that kind of thing. Hopefully they'll get you on a treadmill as well. But yeah, I definitely think that, looking back, I really wish I'd taken the time to go and get them shoes fitted. So that's probably one thing I would definitely recommend. The second thing I wish that was probably I'd looked into earlier when I started running is the technology side of things. There's so much out there now that probably was out there anyway when I started, but I really wasn't aware of it. I think the things are, obviously, the apps. There's probably like a million of them now, which you can track your runs on, your distances, your pace. You can tell people where you are. They count your calories if that's something that you're interested in doing. And I think that's really important, you know, on a motivational point of view, to keep track of what you're doing, to see where your progress is. They're really important to get in, and I wish I'd done that earlier, because I used to just get out the door, run, and not worry about it. But now I wish I'd done that. I think the other thing, important bit of technology, is probably a GPS watch. I got that pretty late, I would say. I went out and got a Garmin one. I now use an Apple Watch, mainly because I like to control my music on it as well. But you don't need to go and spend silly money, but I would definitely recommend also a GPS watch. So the Garmin ones are pretty good, but I got mine on Amazon, like on Black Friday or something like that. So definitely get yourself involved in that. So that's probably the technology that I missed the most and I wish I had earlier. What else? Probably food and hydration. I wish I'd known more about food and how important it is, and obviously hydration, when I started out, because I started out and I was still eating the same rubbish, and I thought, I'm gonna lose weight and whatever. And I was doing the runs, but I wasn't feeling necessarily as probably good as I do now, because I wasn't eating the right things. So it's important that you take the time to research it. I mean, I've done some videos on diet, nutrition for running and stuff like that. Check them out, they're useful. But really look into your food, get a plan, what you're gonna eat, when you're gonna eat, and more importantly, that make sure you're hydrated. That's so important. Runners, when they start out, they don't stay hydrated, and you get headaches and you feel thirsty and you don't realize what a difference it makes to be hydrated. But definitely check out the diet stuff. One thing I would say is, if you are going to run, try and give yourself 2 or 3 hours before you eat, and then before you run, because you want to make sure you get the food digested, and obviously don't have anything stupid before you go out. So like, if I'm running home, I'll have, and that sounds silly, but in the afternoon, at 3 o'clock, I'll have a bowl of porridge, because it's light, it's easy, I know it's going to digest pretty cool, and obviously it's got carbs in it. But so think about that, think about your diet and your hydration. I wish I'd known that earlier, because I think that would have made me a better runner further down the line. Another thing I think is probably, point four now, I wish I'd known about pacing and my routes a bit better when I started out. I think, when I mean pacing, I mean like, what you find with new runners basically is they get their trainers, they think, well, I'm gonna be a hero,
and I'm going to go out and I'm going to run, which is great. I mean, hats off to you for going out and doing it, but you need to get yourself a plan, you need to get a strategy of what you're going to do, because what's going to happen is you're going to go out, you're going to start running, and you're going to be okay, and then you're going to do more running, and then you're going to start thinking, oh, my shins are hurting a bit, or my knee's hurting a bit, or this is hurting a bit. And what you've done is you've gone out too quickly, too fast, and you've got yourself injured. You need to get yourself a plan, you need to get yourself a strategy of how you're going to slowly build up into a running pastime hobby, or whatever your aim is, whether you want to lose weight in a race or whatever, or you're doing it for charity, whatever. But get yourself a strategy, get yourself a plan. There's loads online. I've got some. Check out 40runs.com and get yourself an idea of what you want to do, and incorporate into that some routes. Like, I knew the distance from here to my mother-in-law's was, I think, was it 3 kilometers or something like that. So I knew that I could do that at a jog, and that would take me X. And slowly but surely, I got done that, and I done it quicker. And then I started adding on, like they say, 10%. So use that rule to add on. But it's really important, and I can't emphasize it enough, it's such a stupid thing to say, but start slow. If you're new to running, start slow. Otherwise, all you're going to do is you're going to get injured very quickly, and it's going to kill you, and you're going to be out, and you're going to be resting, and it's just going to be a nightmare. And you're going to wish, like, that you'd never, not that you never started running, but you're going to wish that, you know, you ain't really taking it up, and it's just a pain because your legs are hurting or your knees are hurting. And it's your own fault. It's because you haven't got a plan and you haven't had a strategy. So think about it. Plan what you're going to do. You know, look at, you know, videos like mine, other people's online. Look at websites, get a plan, you know, and then start developing your running and build up your strength, because that's really important. Actually, that brings me on to my, let's call it fifth point. Should be last, really, because I don't want to go too many, but it's strength. Now, I made a big boo-boo. I never went to the gym when I started running. So you've got to think about your gym work. Sorry, I had to think on the front. You've got to start thinking about, when you're taking up running, it's just as important to go to the gym and do strength work as it is to doing your running. And I made a big mistake, and I didn't build up my muscles quick enough. And as I got further running, I wasn't building up the strength of my core. And that is such an important thing. So if you're gonna start running because you wanna, I don't know, get fit, lose weight, or you've got another objective, make sure you add in cardio, and make sure you add in strength work down the gym. I know it's a pain to get down there, and maybe one of the reasons why you're doing running is because it's easy, accessible, and it's cheap. You don't have to pay for gym membership. But, you know, even if you're doing like planks at home and side planks and glute exercises, strengthen your core. I really made a big mistake by not doing that early enough when I started running, and it has affected me further down the road. Like, I got injured because my core wasn't strong enough. So that's a top tip, is to make sure you work on your strength as much as you do on your legs and your distances and your tempo runs and everything else. Make sure you incorporate that into your strategy. That's probably about it. Actually, you know what, one last point, and it's probably the most important, because I just kind of mentioned it. For whatever reason you're running, and this is my final tip for any new runner out there, don't ever forget why you're running. Even now, when I do my running, there's a reason why, whether it's because I'm doing the marathon for charity, or I'm doing the Great North Run for charity, or I'm running a half marathon down in Southend, because I know my little girls are going to be able to see me run past them a couple of times. Make sure you never forget why you're doing the running, and why you're motivated to go out there when it's freezing cold and run, or on the way home and it's chucking down a rain, but you're still out there and you're still hitting the pavements. Keep yourself motivated by remembering why you're doing it, and that's the most important thing. And that's important for any new runner, when it starts getting hard and you start, you know, your legs start hurting and that, because you're new into it. And after a couple of months, believe me, your body will get adapted and you'll get used to it, and you'll start feeling fantastic. But in the dark times, in when you get their mid-run blues, remember why you're doing it, and that's the important thing. So yeah, I think that's it. That's my advice for any new runner out there. I wish I'd known some of those things when I started running. I think that's probably about it. I hope that's useful. If you've got any comments, stick them below. Give me a thumbs up, that's always appreciated. And yeah, if you've got any questions, shoot them over, go to 40runs.com, and you can ping me on there, or check out on Instagram, you can contact me on there. But yeah, and if you are new to running, enjoy it, and I hope you achieve what you want to achieve, and keep running.